Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. If this is your first time, thank you so much for stopping by. I've noticed I've gotten a few more followers in the last few months. Thank you so much for that support. I have an end goal for December 31st of this year to have 1,000 followers. I wrote it down. I sent it out in the universe. Will it happen? Who knows? But because of you guys, it just might. I am going to give you a tour over at Kofi or Kofi. I have a page open. I was inspired by Simone and her page. I used to have a shop over on Etsy, which I closed down about a year ago. I just went down a deep rabbit hole of mental health in the sense that I didn't know what I was creating for. Why was I creating? And also living somewhere where it snows 3 months out of the year didn't really help me either. So I just put it on sabbatical. And then in early 2022, I started getting more creative, going back over on Instagram a lot more, using my new name. It used to be KT Cat Studios, but now we're Paper, Pens, and Kofi because I love anything about papers, pens, and Kofi. So I thought, well, why not use all the items I used over on Etsy and move them over here? So today I'm going to give you a little tour. This is my homepage. I'll put the link down below in the description box for you. This explains a little of why I'm over here. Here's if you want to buy me a cup of Kofi, which is very appreciative. I have not put it up yet, but I am trying to save up the money to put a microphone on my new camera that I got. So then I will be able to do more vlogging style videos instead of voiceover videos. I'm going to put my intro here. This is the feed. I will add items here of updates and things that I'm doing here. And then we have our shop. And this is a lot of fun. These are the stickers that I started my Etsy shop. I was in a project where we had to create something, and being a child of the 80s, I just went right back to the mall scene, and you could smell the iron-on smell or the ironing smell, and you would go into the shop, and if you're from a child of the 80s or a teenager of the 80s, you'll probably remember this. You go in there and they would have all these different designs on the wall and all these different funky letterings, and then you pick, I want number 17 with that lettering and this color and on this shirt. And like 2 hours later, boom, you had your shirt. Granted, it was all iron-on and it probably wouldn't even last 6 months if you washed it a lot and put it in the dryer, because we didn't know better back then that you could, didn't have to put everything in the dryer. So I came up with some different terms, and I put a little blurb on each of them, but I'll just tell you right now. This one is live your story. It's kind of cliche, but not. It's trying to find your way. This would be a reminder of it's your story. It's your journey. It's your journal. It's your art. It's no one else's business except yours. This is the original one that I did. I am. It originally had pink on the sleeves, and then I changed it to this blue. And this is just a statement of I am, and you could fill in whatever. And so this might be a good reminder for you to have on your computer or on your water bottle. Stay weird is, I lived in Portland, Oregon for a while, and this was a very common saying in there, and also in Austin, Texas. Do what you love. I know it's a little cliche, but at the time when I was making these, that was kind of the emphasis in groups that I belonged to. It's like, do what you love. So I just put it down as a reminder. Now this next one, I have two versions of it. This one is the rainbow. Next one is, excuse me, is the orange stripes. And the reason I did both of them is live your truth. Live your truth in what you want to do, how you want to live. Do not, you know, be afraid of anything of it. I'm showing you down here what I wrote. But if, as Jews and Christians alike, when they see a rainbow in the sky, they thank God for the promise they made in their respective faiths. child of the 80s, and even I have some friends that were children of the 90s, and rainbow was everything to us. And also it represents being connected to the LGBTQ plus community, either as part of the community or as an ally. So I felt that I needed to do two types of them, and both of them have been very popular. Let's go back to the shop. I think I have a couple. Oh, two more. These two were made, and I know they're a little large. I apologize, but if you purchase one, you can always fussy cut around it and narrow it down. When I sell out of these, then what I'm going to do is reorder them and cut them down a little. Embrace neurodiversity. Let's go back to the other one. And neurotypical is boring. These two came about when I was finally diagnosed with autism and ADHD at the age 50. It's not like I all of a sudden caught it like a cold. It's always been there, but being a woman, being a girl, we're passed up a lot. I'm just gonna leave it at that. And I was so happy at 50 getting the diagnosis. It really helped me to understand myself and the people that I live with to navigate the waters with me. So that is my coffee shop. I am not here to say you better go over and buy something from me. Just in case you've seen it on the community feed on YouTube here, which I'm so excited. I finally get to use the community feed. So just stop on by and buy me a cup of coffee or buy a sticker or comment on some of the posts I have. That's it for now. See you next time. Thank you for watching. Remember, messy hands, happy life. See you next time. Bye.